in jail, sir?
No.
Have you ever been boned up the ass for being a fucking wise guy?
No.
Okay, then.
Hold on!
Have you ever been in jail, sir?
No.
Have you ever been boned up the ass being a fucking wise guy?
No.
Okay, then. Now maybe you wouldn't have a reason yourself to go on strike, but maybe they did. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, sure. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, sure. Thank you.
Thank you. Hello, you're on the air.
Hello, Nick?
Yes, Nick.
Yeah, I'm a little pissed off. I'm in local 36 Electric Workers Union, and I'm reading in the paper here that the inmates at Attica strike. Now, what right do they got to strike? They're, you know, they lose their rights. And they don't even pay dues.
Have you ever been in jail?
No.
Have you ever been boned up in the ass for being a fucking wise guy? Have you ever been boned up the ass for being a fucking wise guy?
No.
Okay, then.
Hold on!
Ready? Begin.
Have you ever been in jail, sir?
No.
Have you ever been boned up the ass for being a fucking wise guy?
No.
Okay, then. Maybe you wouldn't have a reason yourself to go on strike, but maybe they did. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, sure. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, sure.
Thank you.
The ass of being a fucking wise guy.
No.
Okay, then.
Ready?
Have you ever been in jail, sir?
No.
Have you ever been boned up the ass of being a fucking wise guy?
No.
Okay, then. Now maybe you wouldn't have a reason yourself to go on strike, but maybe they do. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, sure.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah,
sure.
Thank you.
I'm a little pissed off. I'm in Local 36, Electric Workers Union. I'm reading in the paper here that the inmates at Attica strike. Now, what right do they got to strike? They're, you know, they lose their rights. And they don't even pay dues.
Have you ever been in jail?
No.
Have you ever been boned up the ass for being a fucking wise guy? Have you ever been boned up the ass for being a fucking wise guy?
No.
Okay, then.
Ready?
Have you ever been in jail, sir?
No.
Have you ever been boned up the ass for being a fucking wise guy?
No.
Okay, then. Maybe you wouldn't have a reason yourself to go on strike, but maybe they do. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, sure. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, sure.
Always try to give. Welcome to the live stream. I'll say a special greeting to you guys in the concert, but you guys are the first to see the beast in reality. But thank you so much for joining. Leave comments below. We'd love to see you on the live chat, and you'll be monitored by the three excellent studio family staff behind me that you can't see, but their credits are in the comment, in the description below. Yeah, I'll see you guys on the other side. Thank you so much for watching. Good night.
Everybody can hear you.
It's a lie. I love you, Matthew.
Yeah, it's really choppy. I don't know why.
Yes, content. Okay, see you guys on the side. Oh, can you dim the screen as well, Eric?
Sorry?
Can you dim the screen a bit?
Dim? Oh, yeah, definitely. Yep.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks. All right, see you guys.
This is better.
Yeah.
or switch them to silent. This performance is going to be recorded and live streamed, so that's why we just don't want any things going beep in the middle of it. So thank you very much and enjoy.
To our friends who are joining us around the world on the live stream. How many we got, Eric? Give me a number.
We have 35 watching right now.
35 watching right now. The live chat has been filled with memes and it's been really good. So thank you so much to you guys for watching and thank you so much to you guys for joining us in real life here in Callaway Music Auditorium. Now, what you just heard there was Losa by Emmanuel Sejourné, which is a classic in the percussion repertoire, Roomba and Vibraphone, 1990-something. It's a really fun piece that we just learned because it's just really, really short and really fun. So now we're moving on to a piece which is by Kazunori Miyake, who you might know from the Resident Evil series. Actually, he composed the Resident Evil soundtrack. He's a Japanese composer, and he composed this work called Chain, which chains together different elements all together into one piece. So you're going to hear a lot of melodic ideas flowing from one to another. Now, Therese had the brilliant idea of actually adding djembe to it, which is unusual. Normally, it's played without any accompaniment whatsoever. But not only are we adding djembe, we're also swinging it. So it's going to be interesting, but this is Chain. Thank you. we're going to do is completely different now. We're going to go back into stealing other instruments' music. Still, remember, we play a lot of different instruments' music. We play some violin music, we might play some cello music, we steal a lot of Bach. And now, I'm going to play some piano music, right? Repertoire thieves, that's what I call us. No, I really like playing tribute to a lot of other instrument music on marimba. I think it's completely different, like you can't really compare the two versions. And this is a piano solo by Sibelius, of all people. And it's a collection from his five pieces for solo piano. And this is the fifth one called The Spruce. And they're all named after trees. And apparently he wrote this as he was writing a larger symphony. So next time you're procrastinating, just write some short pieces for piano. Might get played on marimba someday. And before I continue, of course, I have to give a shout out to the brand of my marimba. This is my personal marimba here that we put in two hatchbacks and lifted to this venue over here. And the brand is Marimba One, and I have to give a shout out to them because they contributed to this recital very generously. Thank you so much, Marimba One, for your contribution. Now, I'm going to play The Spruce by Sibelius. Okay, the next piece on the program is going to be, or the next two pieces on the program actually, are going to be with Therese. And the first one is called Errol Street. Now, Errol Street was written by Melbourne marimbist Steve Falk, who's also a Yamaha artist. And Steve Falk basically played this on 3MBS in Melbourne as an improvisation in 2016 with Peter Neville and Robert Clark, right? Robert Clark. Peter Neville and Robert Clark just randomly came up with this melody. And then in 2017, he wrote it into actual score form for Therese. So actually this piece is written and performed for and by Therese. So it's actually like Therese's piece. It hasn't even been released yet. But you guys are very lucky today, you're gonna hear it here. And Therese also, fun fact, she won the Australian Marimba competition this year with this piece right here, Errol Street by Steve Falk. So she's gonna play Errol Street first, and then after that, she's gonna play a work by Sydney-based Indonesian composer Robert Owotomo, which is called Fantasy No. 5 As the Snow Falls. And Rob is really well known in many parts of the world for his pieces because they're very elegant, beautiful pieces that are nice and short. So after Errol Street, you're gonna hear Snow. So please welcome Therese. Thank you. Next piece on the program, I hope you guys are enjoying this, by the way. This is meant to be a super casual thing, so thank you so much for joining us again. This next piece on the program is called Lemuria, the Fallen Civilization. Now, both this piece and the last piece on the program, Fantasy, were published by Edition Switzer, which is another one of the people who helped us out with this recital. So thank you so much, Edition Switzer. They actually gave me the score out of 36 scores that they sent me for this piece. So thank you so much, Johan, if you're watching from Denmark. This piece, Lemuria, is evoking the lost civilization of Lemuria. So it's kind of like underwater city vibes. Like the city is very ancient, very hard to find, and it starts off with a chorale, it's very inviting, and then suddenly, bang, boom, destruction, boom, and then the whole city falls down. And then it comes back up again, right? So it's very cinematic, and I really enjoy it. It's a little bit longer than your average Marimba solo. So this is Lemuria by Chava Zoltan Maya.
Thank you.
We've changed the program slightly, so on your programs it says that the next piece is Path, my piece, but it's actually not. It's Kaleidoscope by Chin Cheng Li. We've just swapped them around just because of the last minute decision. But the next piece is going to be Before My Trees, and it's Chin Cheng Li's Kaleidoscope. Now, Kaleidoscope is a very interesting three-movement work. The movements are quite short. I think it's a very exciting works he's playing, but it's by Chin Cheng Lin, who's a Taiwanese rumbus. He's very famous for making very pop song like rumbus solos, but I think this one is the exception. I think this one is more legitimate. This one is good. And Therese is going to be playing with a whole bunch of different mallets, so make sure you count how many she uses, because it's going to be quite a lot. But this is Kaleidoscope. insane. And I hope you guys are also leaving your comment in the live chat below. Have you been screenshotting?
Yep. Nice. There is now 45 people watching the stream right now.
Thank you. Thanks for watching, Matthew. So the next piece on the program, second last piece on the program, is my piece, which is something I thought I'd never say in a million years, because I don't really write stuff, but I had this idea come in my head early this year. I really couldn't get rid of it, so I wrote it down and I released it on my online store on the show, and it's called Path. And it's a very simple marimba solo, the melody is very simple, and it recently got published by Edition Spitzer. You might have seen it on the way in at the door. That's a limited edition copy, there's only five in the world, that's the fifth one. And I was really happy because, yeah, we now have a hard copy as well as a soft copy of this piece. And we played it, we premiered it in Hong Kong. Both Therese and I played it in Hong Kong last week, and it was really great. And so now I'm really happy to bring it home to you guys to present here for its Australian premiere. This is Half.
Oh, sorry, one more bit, sorry.
I always forget this, but I've been holding these mallets the whole time I've got to talk about them. So the final people that I have to thank, if you're watching Junior, Zero Gravity Percussion, which is a small garage, actually. It's a small brand that comes from a garage in Texas. Like, he's just making mallets in his garage. And he makes these mallets called the Jupiters, because they look kind of like Jupiter, the planet. I'm like, they're super affordable. They're made for students. They're like $25. I'm not paid anything to say this, but they did help us with this recital. So thank you so much for sending me these, and thank you so much for your support. Zero Gravity, this is Path. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank yous, because this thing wouldn't have happened without the support of a lot of people. Firstly, of course, to the people I've already mentioned, Zero Gravity Percussion from Texas, Marimba One from Arcata, California, Edition Switzer from Denmark, as well as the Studio Family, which is, you might see that some of my friends are wearing these merch hoodies. It's because they're part of the Studio Family who contributes to this recital as well. Thank you so much, that's you guys. And of course, thank you so much to the University of Western Australia School of Music for having us here. They very generously gave us the opportunity to have Therese to have a masterclass this morning, which I think the percussion guys really liked over here. And also to have this wonderful place that I've called home for the last 5 years. I really like this place a lot, as you can tell. I mean, fourth recital in 4 years, they're gonna get rid of me soon. I also want to thank, of course, Therese for coming all the way here. Doing all of this. Teresa's family, if you're watching, thank you so much. My family for doing all of this. And also my mum has cooked an amazing feast outside. There's like a million wontons waiting for you guys outside. Okay. She spent hours making these for you guys. So you guys are the lucky ones. You guys don't get to eat it, sorry. Okay. But that's that. And also Louise Devenish, if you're here. Where's Louise? Louise. Yeah, woo! Louise. Shout out to Louise because she has supported me through this journey since I was a naive third year who couldn't play marimba properly until now. Thank you so much, Louise, for your support, and thank you to also Tim White and Paul Tanner, all my other teachers. Thank you all, you guys, for coming to this recital. This is a crazy thing that we've put together, and I really hope you've enjoyed. So the final piece on the program, 2 5-octave marimbas, and it's a bit of Piazzolla. Now, if you don't know Piazzolla, he writes a lot of tango music. And this last work is from the Matthew, you're going to kill me for this. Estación es poten. Estación es poten, which is like the four seasons of Buenos Aires. And this is the summer movement called Verano Porteño. And basically, there is no arrangement for Verano Porteño available for marimba duo. There's a very famous one performed by Pius Cheng and Eric Odaino, but it's not written. So what could we do? You know, we're not like very good at using surveillance. So what can we do? So instead we use a piano duo transcription from Pablo Ziegler, shout out to Pablo, and we changed it for marimba, and I think it sounds really cool. We played this in Hong Kong last week, and we're very excited to present to you this version of Verano Porteño. Thank you so much for joining us in this recital, and we'll see you afterwards, okay, out there. Thank you. All right, we're back.
Wait.
Oh, Therese, come here.
Okay, yep.
Thank you so much for watching, guys. Thank you for watching. Please leave a comment down below. Thank you for all the support. Thank you, Therese, for playing this with me. This is insane. Thank you, Eric. Thank you, Jasmine. Thank you, Wilson, for supporting us in this crazy endeavor. You guys are awesome. Where's the live chat? Whoa. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you for all the kind comments. Look at that.
Shout out to Adam's mom.
Shout out to Adam's mom. Yeah, she's outside making the food right now. Thanks, Stephen. Wow, look at all these comments. Did anyone say we suck?
Of course not.
Therese uses Burton. I know her personally. Yes, you do, Matthew. Yes, you do. You don't even know how to hold six mallets. Therese does. I play room in the pit. Steve Falk.
Steve Falk.
Shout out to Steve. Thank you, Steve. Wow. Don't worry, guys. I'll upload the program and also the full recital pieces on the studio channel. But thank you so much. Sibelius was really writing for me. But yeah, he was, Alex, actually. Thank you, guys. Thank you, all of you guys. Sorry about the lag problem. Sorry about the early problems. But we fixed it thanks to Eric's genius plan. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. You guys are awesome. You guys are all awesome. Oh, Matthew. Matthew. I love you, Matthew. Thank you for waking up at 6. I appreciate it. I'm sorry it's a bad time for you guys, but thank you. You guys are awesome. Sophia said congratulations.
Sophia.
Come over here, Therese. Go meet your fans.
Sophia, did you only watch the last note again?
Yo, Matthew! Riley! Thank you, guys. Thank you so much. Thank you. Wow. Eric, what's the view count?
So we have.
Did we ever hit past 50?
Let's see.
Thank you, guys. Thank you so much. Wow.
So according to
47. Oh, we did.
According to that, so we have 508 playbacks.
Nice. Very good, Eric. Very good.
It's all you.
No, you are my inspiration, man. You are. You guys are our inspiration. Thank you so much for your support. Oh, isn't this crazy? This is crazy. This whole thing is crazy.
This live stream couldn't be successful without your fans, really.
Not fans, they are our friends.
Friends.
Eric, they're our friends.
Sorry, friends.
Thank you. Oh, Sophia says she watched the whole thing, darling. She calls you darling. Hey, Therese, come and greet Sophia while she's still watching.
I miss you, Sophia.
Can't believe we just did that. That's crazy. Oh, thank you. Alright, guys, we're probably going to end the stream right now, but thank you so much for watching. Again, this is going to be available as a playable video, but we're also going to upload the real videos afterwards. Full thanks to Wilson for recording all of that. Thank you to Jasmine for monitoring the levels. She's over there. She's not saying hi. Hi, Jasmine. Look at that upside down view. Oh, there she is. Yay. So yeah, thank you so much, guys. We're gonna go and eat now. I hope you guys have a good sleep if you stayed awake for us. Sorry about that. Perf time zone. But I will see you guys in the next episode of The Studio. You'll see Therese as well, and you'll see all of these guys probably again very, very soon. Thank you so much for watching, and good night. Good night. Shoo!